Well, here we are in another episode of Do You Know What To Do? We're back in the shop with the sofa that we tore down in part one, and we're going to show you how to put the sofa back together so it looks like it never was touched. Before we started rolling the video, we added dowels to all the rails where the frame was cut. And why did we add dowels?
To add extra strength, which is very important.
It is important. And the last upholsterer didn't have it. It just used plates. And that's okay. I mean, it got many years of service with just the plates. But we wanted to add a little extra strength to it, so we put the dowels in. Now, if you want to take this route, we're going to show you how to do it quickly and effectively using just simple hand drill and piece of paper and of course the dowels. So what we're going to do is take this frame apart. You see it together now, but it's a dry fit. Grant and I didn't add any glue because we want to make sure all the dowels are going to line up. So do this, or do that rather, make sure they're all going to line up before you add any glue. Okay, so let's take it apart and show them how we did it.
All right.
These are the dowels that we were talking about. As I said, we didn't put any glue in here, so we can easily take it apart. But we put two in each rail. We have a total of four rails that we put dowels in. One here, one at the back, one at the inside back at the bottom, and then one at the top up there. So each rail we put two. Now, it's very important that they line up. Isn't that right, Grant?
Yeah.
Very important. And I'm going to show you how to do that just simply using a piece of paper and a pencil. So this is how we made the dowel holes. And this is how you can do this simply with a piece of paper. All I did is I took a piece of paper and I went to the edge of the paper so you don't have to do four cuts. Just like that. Take a pencil, mark the arrow up. Okay. Then I cut this right where my creases are, right? And fold it in half. It doesn't have to be perfect. Just gives you a little guidance, a little something to go by. Double check to see how it fits. Oh yeah, I'm gonna clean that up just a little bit. Okay. All right, good enough. Now, we cut it in half to get the center. I mean, we fold it in half rather to get the center. Put it back up there. And then do the best you can as far as where you think the center will be, going from the top to the bottom to the side. Somewhere about right around there looks pretty good. Then we took a small drill bit, or you could use a punch. A punch is better, but if you don't have one, then just use a small drill bit right where your pencil mark is. Tap like that and make a dent in the wood. Don't move your paper yet. Do the same thing on the other side. So I'll demonstrate it on here. Basically, you hold it there, make a dent, don't move your paper, put it where your other pencil mark is, a little dent like that, come down here, obviously you see them, make even more of an indentation, take a hand drill, try to keep it as level as you can, put this pilot hole in there, make a pilot hole rather, put this drill bit in, make a pilot hole. Then find the size of the drill bit, or yeah, that the drill bit needs to be for your dowel. Ours are small dowels. It's okay though. It'll work. You can get bigger ones. This is a 5/16, okay, by 1 3/4 inch long. So we got a 5/16 inch drill bit and went up here, obviously, but drilled here.
So what is the use of the pilot hole?
This is a good question. The use of the pilot hole is so your drill bit doesn't crawl. You don't want it to crawl on you because obviously it's not going to be accurate. So the little point of your drill bit fits in the hole there a little bit easier. And it makes it a little bit more accurate. You know, you could probably do it without the pilot hole, but why not have the extra security? I'm a type of person that I want to do it once.
And better safe than sorry.
Yeah, I want to do it right. So if you got a better method, great, do that. But just make sure it doesn't crawl on you, okay? That's why I do it, so it doesn't crawl on us, so we get a more accurate measure or hole. Now, we showed you how to make the hole centered in the top rail here, or any rail that you're going to use using this piece of paper template. But it's very important that your holes line up on the other rail, the adjoining rail. So Grant's going to show you how to make sure that the holes that you're going to drill will line up with the holes you drilled at first. So Grant, show them how to do it.
So you want to take your paper template and you want to put it right over top of the holes where you were before, line it up, and you want to make an indentation with your finger over top of the holes, okay? And then what you want to do is you want to transfer it like this. You don't want to turn around because if you turn around, it's going to be on the opposite sides. So you want your right to be right and your left to be left. Once we put that over there, you take your puncher and then put it right in the holes and then make an indentation with your hammer, just as we showed last time. After you do that, the holes should line up perfectly and it makes it a lot more secure.
Okay, so then we did the 5/16 inch drill and you're going to see this masking tape on here, and that is because you want the proper depth. You don't want to have, let's just use this as an example, you don't want to have it sticking out that much and then you don't have enough depth in the connecting rail and now you got a gap, you got to take it apart and then drill it again. So this is a guide, you know, it's a little guide. You can do this very easily with masking tape. I went in 1 inch and it seemed to work quite well, so I'd stop when I got to the paper there. And then Grant and I put in the dowels and all the places here. And pull this one out. Set that in there. Tapped them. And it's so important. Look at that. See, it's going all the way in. It's very important that you do a dry fit. Don't put any glue on this thing yet, because that's going to be a mess. So that's what we did. And that's how we did it. You can do it too with a simple piece of paper, a small drill bit for the marking of the wood, and then the proper size drill bit for the dowel. And then if you want bigger dowels, you can do that as well. So we added some extra security. We're still gonna put on the plates.
Yeah.
So it lasted years without the dowels. I just like that, knowing that it's really strong. And that's the way fine furniture is done, is with dowels and dovetailing. So that's it. Now we gotta get to putting this thing together.
Okay.
All right. Now this video actually showed two different parts. One, if you need to just take the arm off, which is a common practice to get large pieces of furniture out of tight spaces, and also cutting the frame. So that was two parts really, what this video is showing you. So what we want to do is we want to put the arm on first before we put the frame together. And the reason being is there's going to be a little bit of stapling at the bottom. I don't want to have to flip the whole sofa up just to get to the bottom of the arm once we already have the frame all glued and doweled together. It's going to be a little bit lighter, a little bit easier. So that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to show you the arm. And what we're doing this for, keeping the fabric, I should say, is we want to show you as if you're going to keep the top fabric. This is being reupholstered, so normally I wouldn't be messing with this. I would just go about putting it together and then putting on the new fabric. But since we're trying to show you how to do this if your furniture is in a tight area, then I'm trying to preserve the fabric that was originally on here. So take this off and let's put this off to the side.
Now remember too, is that with earlier, if you have a sofa that's too long, the arm is not gonna help. So you wanna leave the arm on and, as we did, cut the sofa in half.
That's right, that's the only way it's gonna get out. If you have to make a 90 degree turn like we did, it's not going to get out there with just taking the arm off. We just had an added bonus there in case that would solve your problem. So what we're going to do is put this back in its place. And we have some gluing and some nailing to do.
All right.
It sits on the top there. I'm gonna hold this up. So we see we got some nailing and gluing to do here and in the back and on the top back here. Of course, we're going to show you each little spot, but that's as we do it. But we're just trying to give you the overview. Find all the places in which you cut it, and then have to put glue and brad nails back in there, if you like, or finishing nails. And I'll show you what a finishing nail is as well. What I'm doing in this part is I'm trying to drive the staples out of the rail. Back at the house, Grant and I just simply knocked it right on out, and the staple stayed in that rail, but I don't want them to keep them in there. I don't really want to reuse them because it's not going to have a strong hold. So I'm going to back them out of there and then replace them. Little idea to drive the staples out is take needle nose pliers, grab the end of the staple, take a small hammer if you have like a tack hammer, and just hit the end of the needle nose while you're squeezing very hard at the end of the staple. It helps drive it out because they want to bend over. They're very long. They want to bend over. When they start to bend over, they're not going to come out. But you do want them out of the way, if you can get them out of the way.
So now after that, we took out the staples. We are going to put dowels right in between where the staples were. So right here and right there. So these two spots. And after that, we were going to take this off and glue this, but you know, we might as well put the dowels there and then make it all complete.
Yeah, exactly. So to put the dowels in there, we're going to have to remove this. We wanted to anyhow, it's so weak. So that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to knock this off. Look how easy it comes off here. Okay, simple. But see, we got to make the template for here and then transfer it to that rail. We think it might be a better idea. I mean, don't get me wrong. It did last many, many years with just the staples. But the dowels right there, considering people are going to be sitting back there and such, obviously, having a seat, that I want to give a little added strength to it.
And they have kids, so the kids are going to be playing on the back and on the arm, so.
Yeah, exactly. So we don't want to reupholster this thing and then you get a weak spot. Because we did take, you know, a good portion of the frame apart, cut it right in half. So we want to make sure that it's strong. So that's what we're going to do next. We're going to make the dowel, same way we just showed you over here. So we're going to get to that, and when we're finished, we'll get back to you.
All right. So our cameraman was wondering the difference between these two hammers. You might be wondering the same. So let's take this step by step. This one is a tack hammer. This is only used for tacks. Now tacks are what hold the fabric, and this part is magnetic. You hammer it in, flip it over, and tack it in. Now the second one, this is for decorative nails. Now these are the nails that you actually see. They're on the corners or the outside of the fabric, and then you they add, well, decorative value. So the reason for the nylon part is so you don't ruin that decorative value. So you just hammer it in, and the nylon protects it. So that's the difference between these hammers. So if you want to use decorative nails, this is the hammer you should go with, and tacks.
So now I drilled the holes for the dowels to drop down in here. I'm going to put a little glue using this glue syringe, which you can get at any hardware store or definitely a wood shop online. They're really good. You'll like them. Tap that in there. So we just now finished putting the dowels in there, and that is extremely strong. That's going to be just fine. I'm going to leave the clamp on for a little bit longer. 30 minutes for set, 24 hours for complete curing. So we're going to glue this together, let it sit for a day, maybe even two. The fabric's not in to reupholster, so we're still waiting for that to arrive. And it's going to be extremely strong. So what we're trying to do now is we're working on this side of the frame, not this one yet. We have the dry fit in there. We didn't put it together yet. We didn't fasten it together. We didn't glue it together yet. We're just putting that together so everything lines up on this end. So I would recommend doing that as well. So now we're just finding out where these pieces go together. We did put dowels here. We put dowels on the bottom down here. I've got to glue this, so we're going to glue that. And then we're going to go to the front, glue that as well, and staple. We got a couple of areas to actually do the stapling. This gap here was there at the house. That's kind of normal on a lot of frames. We're going to pull it in the best we can like this, but it was a bigger gap there before than when we're going to be finished with it. It's going to be tighter. We'll put some glue there, and we'll put some staples there as well. So that's our next move.
All right.
Now we just move the clamp right over top of the dowels because we have to work on the bottom rail here, which we did earlier. So we already pulled it apart because it was just dry fit. And what are we going to do next then?
So we're going to put these in, glue it,
mm-hmm.
and then
put it together. All right, excellent. So like I said, the little syringe glue works out perfectly there. Just put a little bit in those holes there.
All right. Okay. There we are.
Okay. Whenever you're doing glue work, even on a frame, it's a good idea to have a wet rag, wet towel, and clean up as you go along. You know, bulky pieces of glue.
Okay.
It's not necessary.
Now, let's see. How would you like to get into these holes right here?
Well, you know what? Let me have this. Yeah, go ahead and do that. That's okay. I'll tell you what, I think I can get it from this angle here.
Good.
Yeah, just fine. Oh, it's coming out a little bit. I'm going to put it in this hole here.
Where's the rail?
On that rail.
Yeah. There you are.
Yeah, I hate having bulky pieces of dried glue. So if you can clean it up.
Yeah.
Okay, did you get that? Did you glue that rail there?
Yeah.
You did?
The outside part, no.
Okay. Now I'm going to pull this in just a little bit. Get it off our table. Clamp off.
All right.
Okay, is it all right?
Yep. So, obviously, as you can see, you have to have a work table. Because if you do this on your carpet, this glue's not going to get out. So, just don't even mess with that. Just lay down a tarp or something like that. So...
get this down in there.
Okay. Good, one in.
Mm-hmm.
And I got the other one.
You got the other dowel?
Yep.
Put that one in.
You got me? Where am I? There.
You got it.
Okay.
Is it all the way in?
I think so.
Okay, now let's line it up. Okay. Is this knocking it off the pressure of the clamp?
I think so. This
okay,
how's
that?
Got it.
Okay, let's push that together.
All right.
Keep going, yeah, go. Perfect.
Okay.
Okay, so you get to see it from this angle here. I'm going to clean that excess glue up. So that's where the two dowels are, right there.
Right.
So it goes pretty flush. Not bad. This one's definitely flush. That one's in just a little bit, but it'll be fine. It's much better than what it was before.
Yeah.
We just had those little staples, and you can see how easy it is to knock off. Like, take, for example, look at this here. So you can see the gap. That's there. I'm going to put a little glue in there, and I'm going to try to tap that one down. And the glue will hold it and just fine. But see if I can get it to go flush.
Yes.
If not, maybe I'll put a dowel in there.
As you just said, there's no glue in there now. So
yeah, I know.
We're going to make it stronger.
If there is any, it didn't hold.
No.
So glue's not forever. So that's what we're doing. We're just putting all the joints together, putting dowels where we see them necessary, especially at the joints where it takes a lot of pressure. This one's not as much. It's not that bad. It's really to keep this from bowing is what that's for, and a pull rail. So to pull the fabric around. So that's what that is, that particular rail there. So things going pretty well.
All right,
let's go. Here's a quick little tip for you. So if you're concerned, are you going to get the rail back in the same spot? Like, for example, the factory has it recessed just a little bit here in the front, and it's flush in the back. Simply go to the side and make a mark like that. We were fortunate because when we knocked this thing off, there's a little chip of wood there from the factory due to glue, so we knew it was lining up because the crevices were perfectly lined. But to make it easier on yourself, just simply do a line like that, knock it off, and then you'll know how to line it back up. Like, for example, I'm going to work on this one. I might just drill a hole in here and put a dowel through here. When you see joints that aren't flush, that happens all the time with frames. I've seen with gaps this big, and they're fine. I mean, it'd be nice if they did come together like a perfect puzzle, but they don't always. But if you can make it flush, as long as you're not distorting the frame by making it flush, then I would keep it that way. So for example, this one here, I may make a mark here and then down on the side. And I know that's where the factory wanted that to be. So I want to keep it where they had it. Grant and I decided to go ahead and just put some glue here. We're not going to put any dowels there. We don't think that's necessary. It's very strong. And with the glue, it'll be, you know, even stronger. So we tried to use tools that you can find at your local hardware store. We try to use fasteners, nails, screws, things like that you can use at your hardware store. And you can find the dowels there too. I said earlier I was going to tell you what a finishing nail is. I got the large one that we have in stock here at our shop. And this is a finishing nail. It doesn't have much of a head at all. And they call it a finishing nail because when you put it in casing around wood, put up in crown molding, up on ceilings and stuff like that, you'd actually put the nail in, you'd have a punch, and you would drive it past it, fill it with putty, and it's finished after you paint. So that's what you can use for this particular job. It's equally strong as any staple that they use from the factory. This is a bit of an overkill. You can get a smaller one if you want. So what we need to do, back to our project, is this is the arm. This is the top of the arm, and it's just sitting on a brace here. So the factory used staples, and as you can see, we cut those free, or as you saw in the part one, we cut those free back at the house. And we don't use staples like that in our shop. We would use dowels or maybe, you know, finishing nails, and sometimes screws too. That works well. Dowels are the best. I mean, yeah. If you can use dowels, definitely use dowels. But we're trying to do it as if you're not using dowels, you're just going to the hardware store, you're getting finishing nails. You can use any other nail if you want. It doesn't really matter. I mean, you can use a framing nail.
Nobody will see it, so.
No, it's fine. Just don't make it bulky. You know, the padding goes right over top of it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put glue on here. We're going to line this up where it was, and that's where those Sharpie marks come in quite handy. But thankfully, we can tell where the wood lined up on here. And we are either going to, I don't know if we're going to put dowels or we're going to put finishing nails. But either one's going to work fine for you. So that's our next move. Okay, as you can see, we just put the last dowel into the wood brace right here. Obviously, we just went with dowels. I like using dowels. But I wanted to tell you, if you're going to use dowels by going straight into another piece of wood, you have to make your drill bit setting at the length of the dowel. So ours is 1 3/4, and I put the masking tape 1 3/4 on the drill bit, went straight down in there, and you can see it's nice and flush. That's not going anywhere. We added glue to it, glue inside the holes that the dowels go in, and it's doing really well. So we're still working around the bottom or the back side of the frame, and we have one more rail here that is loose. As you know, we just did the top ones here with the dowels, and I want to put a dowel on this one too. The wood's getting real chewed up from taking it apart and such. So I want to put a dowel in here, but I want to put it together attached to your dry fit first to make sure that that's in its right spot. So that's what Grant and I are going to do right now. We're going to put it together, dry fit, come over here, drill a hole in here for the dowel, a little bit of glue, boom, right in there, and then we're going to move around the side. Now it's time to move on the side of the sofa. We're going to come over here and see what needs to be done. All this here, as you can tell, is one unit. This piece right here, this piece. The only thing that's secured in this particular area right now is this board with the three dowels that we put on the top. So we have this spot here that needs help, and this spot here as well. So what Grant's going to do is we already put a little glue there. I'll put a little bit more in here. And we're going to pull this together like this, and I will put some staples there to hold it in place. What I have in my gun now, hopefully you have a pneumatic gun. I change out my 3/8 inch staples for a 9/16, put those in, they're longer, and pull this together like that. Okay, I know it's lining up, that's where the old staple marks are from the factory, so go ahead and put in. It's the same concept that the factory did, but those aren't strong enough to leave alone. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put a nail in right here, and I'm going to use one of the finishing nails. Now this is one with the head on there, This one here, I cut off with some nips. Just simply take your nips here like this and cut that off. Now, why did I do that? Because you can put it in a drill like this just to get a pilot hole. Now, it's going to be the same size because you're using one of the nails, right, Grant?
Right.
So you don't want to go all the way in. You just want to get it started a little bit. If you're working on stiff woods and things like that, hard woods, I should say, they'll split like oak. This is not oak, but nonetheless, that's a little trick you can do that. So I'm going to line this up about, say, right there. Does it look good?
Yeah.
I'm going to stop right there. Maybe I'll go a little bit further. Stop right there. That gives me a pilot hole. Thank you. Now, by me nailing this down now, it's going to help hold these because this won't last long. And then we're going to put a screw up at an angle here. Okay, that's not going to go anywhere. So that will hold this in place. I'm going to do a pilot hole in the bottom of here. And make sure you get a drill bit that's not bigger than the screw. So say a drill bit like this, and I'll reach over here and grab a screw. And you would hold it up. If you still see threads and it's the size of the shaft, then you're good to use that drill bit. But don't use the same size. Don't use one larger because obviously the screw is not going to hold. So I'm going to pre-drill, or Grant is going to pre-drill at an angle up here and put a screw right up like this, just like that. And then here, I think I'm going to put some dowels in there. I just love using dowels. They're great. So dowels here, screw here. I think this section is done. Okay, that was the last dowel in there, securing this arm on there quite well. So you can see this is getting very strong, actually.
Stronger than it was before.
I think it is. I think it definitely is. And we got the curing time of 24 hours, too, for the glue. So that'll make it even stronger. So now we got one more part to finish off the arm, and it's right up here. As you can see, the old staple holes are here from the factory. Back at the house, we took the saws off, or a reciprocating saw, and cut all those staples free. So we're going to tap this up. Put a little glue underneath here, something like this. Pull this forward, put some glue in the front, little glue down here. We're gonna pre-drill.
Put some dowels in there.
I love dowels, okay? We're gonna put dowels in there. And then probably two screws. And then that's good to go. When we're done with that, we're gonna move on to the support webbing there. So let's get to it.
All right. You know, it's always a good idea to clean up as you're going, so it's not just one big mess at the end.
Little tip idea, if you find yourself hitting some of the staples that are still remaining in the wood when you're pre-drilling for either a screw or a dowel, your drill bit should be able to cut through it if your drill's strong enough. So you don't have to stop, just have enough power in the drill. Battery-wise, that is, or plug-in will definitely be fine. It'll rip right on through it. So I just hit one a minute ago. I got right past it.
When you're finished drilling the holes for dowels, make sure you keep your area clean as well as the holes, because if any debris is stuck in there, the dowels might get stuck halfway or something like that, and it won't really hold that well. So take we have a dirt devil right here. You can use that kind of vacuum, or also you can use compressed air and blow it out. Either one works fine, but it's very important to keep those holes clean.
Okay, the arm is secure and complete.
All right.
So tell them what's next.
All right, so the next step that we're gonna do is we're going to do the support webbing right here. Just pull it pretty taut. You can take some pliers. Don't pull it too taut because you're gonna rip as you can see right here, there's staple holes. You're just gonna rip the staple holes right out, and you're gonna ruin the webbing. So just pull a little bit, kind of taunt, and then staple.
Pull down, look it down this direction.
Okay.
It's important too to fold it back over. That's pretty good. You just want a little support underneath the fabric. So now we got the back side to do as well, just as tight as you can. Okay.
Flip it over.
This is down.
Sorry.
That's cool. Now we have here too, if you can come around here with the camera, we got this foundation fabric that you can pull tight as well. So basically we're putting it back the way we took it apart. I had to get this off, I had to get this off back at the house to get the arm off, and that's what we're trying to do now. So we're just going to pull this nice and tight as well. We're going to pull a little bit more on this and put some staples back in here, putting it exactly the way it was at the factory, and that's what we're going to do next. Okay, that's all complete. The foundation fabric's on, and so is the inside arm webbing. Now, Grant, what would happen? Tell the people what would happen if their dry rotted jute webbing was no longer usable, or this actually synthetic webbing here was torn when they try to reapply it. Not only could they just replace it with jute webbing or synthetic webbing, but what's another alternative?
Well, they could use cardboard. This is a very high density cardboard. It's not very flimsy, but it is still thin. So that's important.
It is, and it's used in a lot of furniture manufactured all over the world. This I actually got from a book binding supply company in Beltsville, Maryland, and I did it for a couple of Wassily chairs that I did in the past. They had it sandwiched between canvas material. So you could use that, and it feels really good. When that thing's solid there, even though you think, cardboard, but it's pretty nice. I mean, it feels like a solid piece of furniture, like a quality piece, and that's something you can do, or just go get some more webbing. Now that the arm's complete and ready to go, we're going to put the two bodies together. And then the next move is we've got to take the dowels out on one side, put glue in all the holes, put the dowels back in there, and then glue the other side. So that's our next move. You know, it's very important that you don't break the dowel pulling it out. So easy to do. It's kind of hard using your fingers sometimes when it's really snug. So get a pair of needle nose pliers. But don't pull them so hard that you break it in half, because if it breaks inside there, you're going to have to drill that out and put a new one in. So be careful when you're pulling them out. Now let's get the glue. We'll glue all this up, put those dowels back, and then glue this side up as well. It's a little harder to get the dowels to go in when there is glue. It's taking up space. So I just tap a little bit more. Don't hit it too hard. You can crack it in half. I'm just tapping it. Let the hammer have the weight.
The sad thing about these rubber mallets is that they are great for hitting something that you don't want damaged, but they absorb a lot of the punch. So even though they feel heavier, they don't do as much.
Okay, now we have glue on both sides. Now we're going to glue the rail themselves. We'll glue this up here. You go ahead and do that.
Okay.
Glue up. And just trying to get that excess off. Go ahead and just glue all the parts that are going to connect.
Okay.
And then I'll go on the back and I'll do the same when you're finished. Here's the rag. Now we glued the face of all the rails, and just keep the excess down as much as possible. let's get together and then we'll clean all the excess off. So Grant, do you want to go in first in your slot?
I think you go first. You have more. Keep it on your top one.
Okay, are you in?
Nope. Yeah, let's see. You pull it in on head.
Okay, one, two, three. Perfect. Keep hitting it. Wait, stop. Stop. The fabric's caught. Okay, go ahead.
Got it.
Let me go from here.
All right.
Now, let's do that staple trick just to hold them together.
All right.
So start to cure. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. You want to do yours there, Fred?
Sure.
Okay, we got the 9/16 in here. If you can pull that together as much as you can. Got your glasses? Put your glass on there.
You good?
Pull this. I mean, it's doing quite well, man. Pull that in.
Like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hammer that bottom in with the rubber mallet, please. Okay, go. Pull it in. Okay, what we did that for is just to hold it in place so it doesn't shift on us. And we're still going to put the braces back on that the other upholsterer had. And we're going to put three in the front, just like he had. He had one up here, one down there, I think two in the back here. So we're going to put that on, and that's the next thing we're going to do. We're just about done on this thing. All right, that is the last plate, so we're good to go. We glued all the dowel holes. We put all the plates in where they were. And by the way, you can get these plates at any hardware store. They're just basically metal plates. Someone can help you find them. Simple. Maybe get, I think these are probably like maybe 6-inch metal plates, maybe an inch thick. So you can find those at any hardware store. You're going to need them. And I would encourage you to do the dowels if you're up for it. Do the template the way we did it. It makes it much stronger. So the next move is we got to let it cure for 24 hours. Don't use your sofa. Don't get all excited. Keep going forward if you want, because you need this glue to cure. Very important that it cures so it gives you the fullest strength that it can. Next step, we're going to put back all the foundation fabric, the padding and the foam and things like that, and we're good to go. Now we're going to keep the top fabric so it's as if you are going to use this as your piece of furniture, that you're not going to have it reupholstered. So that's the whole point. This is getting reupholstered, as I already said. It's going to be done in the denim, and it's going to look pretty nice. So I think they know what to do now. What do you think?
I think so. Thank you.
Now, before we got on camera, I did a little extra ad blah, man. This is going to be days. Nothing. I just boogered it up.
What did you do?
We're still going to put the plates back on as he did or had on earlier. And I just totally messed that up, didn't I?
There's no glue, and it's basically...
That's not easy, is it? Okay, so... So we took it a little extra further in on this.
We took it a little further.
Before we started filming, we added dowels to all the rails of the sofa frame.
And these dowels actually add strength. What happened?
What? Did I do something?
No, I can't remember what I'm supposed to say. What did I say at the first? The other one was perfect. Back here at the shop? No, before the film round. Okay, before we started videoing. They had it in sandwiched in between canvas material. I got this at a bookbinding supply company in Beltsville, Maryland. And did I mess that up? I guess I did, didn't I? Now we have all the arm glued. Everything's completed. It's all complete. I just messed it up. Now that the arm's complete, now we're moving on to the body. We're going to put the two... Now that the arm's glued and ready to...
Do what? What do we do?
Come on. Just put enough glue in to hold the dowel, of course. Like, don't even put that in there. I mean, like, mine's dripping out like waterfalls. Okay, now let's get glue on this side.
Somebody has to use the bathroom.
Let's be mature here, okay? Let's be mature. Now we need to... Okay, I'm working here, people. I really gotta get this back to the client.
For,
this lady's been standing this whole time. I've had this sofa.
All right, you can cut that out, right?
Mm-hmm.